was the first time that I saw Sayginer visit my club in Mechelin. And I was practice with him. And really, he plays so nice. I saw it immediately also, the way he played.
It was my first tournament I met Sayginer, and he amazed me because he was playing so easy, you know, you just, because at that time you were like, oh, we have to calculate the ball, you know, we have to look at the angle, but he was not looking to anything, just playing and playing pure talent. He was really, really pure talent.
Moving his cue, that was fantastic, so smooth, and say, yeah, you ought to be right, I'm sure you ought to be a really good player. And afterwards, we see that he was one of the best in the world.
Some people very special, very mystic person. So between billiard players, we feel exactly when another people has something special.
Sayginer opened the eyes of everybody, I think, and I was really interested to watch his matches because things happened. At the table, on the table. Really interesting to watch and many, many things to learn.
Sayginer was my favorite player to watch. His style was unique for me.
Sayginer's cueing style was very special. He was stroking in a way that nobody had ever seen before.
I think he was one of the greatest player with 100% feeling. He feels the game, he feels the ball, he feels everything. And at that time he amazed me, really. And still amazed me because he was a really unique player, I think. Great player and unique player also. Nobody was like Sayginer.
And Sayginer had a special way of controlling three balls and never being sloppy, taking care. He was a fast player, but he always took care. He didn't do any things at random or something. He tried to control everything. That was really interesting.
He was a very cool guy. Even in difficult moments, in tough moments, when he was missing a position, he never showed emotions. He had always a very cool face and cool expression.
Because three cushion is played with your brains. And that was where he was very, very strong. He influenced a whole group of players, a whole game, by the way he was playing. And then I mean his tactical, his planning of the shots and his execution, not his physical style.
I think he put a very, very big scratch in the history of billiards, that everybody will remember him as Sangli. He's not like anybody else. I'm really happy to be a fan of him.
I think everybody in Europe remembers Sangli as a very, very special player. And after a while, I became really close friend with him. And I think he felt the same for me too.
But I remember him as a great champion and also a good friend. And that's the reason also that I've been here for the first memory of Sangli.
Sangli was a good friend of mine, and I miss him.
Sangli has a place in the heart of every free cushion player, a really special place, because I think nobody loved the game as much as he did. And we're all missing him real bad. And every time we play in the United States or everywhere in the world, we are playing a little bit for him also. It was a very special friend, and he the way he loved the game is glorified everything that we are doing, and we're very, very thankful to him.